We've all been there, looking for that damned elusive Pimpernel. Acid. No acid trip here, just a lot of trips and no acid. It's like the acid gate is happening, where it seems to exist everywhere, but we never find it anywhere. But this pro tip today is where and how to obtain it to increase your chances of finding it. But beware, it is still random and it doesn't guarantee, but it does significantly increase your chance of finding it if you're at least looking in the right spot. And at the end, make sure you stay to the end, I'll leave a really good tip for how to really, really increase your chance of finding acid. It's not so easy to get there, but it really will make a big difference. So make sure to acid up that thumbs up like button and subscribe as we get started. And the first thing is in junk. Yes, you heard it. We can go to the XML to verify, and you will see here in the group junk 02, there is this mention of where it can appear in the group crafting uncommon. And if we then look at the group crafting uncommon, we can see you actually can find some acid, but it has a low probability. And because it's nested, you know, that just makes it even harder because there's a lot of things that can show up in the junk, but you can find it there, and junk is everywhere. Second easily accessible place is in cars. Basically, you have to loot those cars over and over and over again. As a bonus, car loot is generally better than many other commonly accessible storage containers. So every car you find, you can loot. Do so. Weapons, gear, ammo, armor, tools, and sometimes acid. Next up, houses. Residential houses are filled with acid possibilities. Firstly, you have the garage. You know, make sure you go to the garage and open those storage boxes and you have a chance to find that acid. But of course, that's not all. Sinks have long been a loot favorite in houses, as you can find wrenches, but there's also a chance to find some acid. So get into that kitchen. It's a nice place to loot some leftover food as well. Don't forget that coffee machine. It can have coffee or coffee beans. Make sure you don't neglect heading to the bedroom and the offices. And I'm not talking about going for a nap or from remote work during the COVID period. No, believe it or not, desks, whether they're the wooden desks or the metal desks, sometimes store acid. It's really weird. I mean, how many people of us have acid in our desks? Sinks, yes. Desk, no. Perhaps even more weird, those nightstands, as you can see, can also contain acid. So, you know, be a little bit careful about that. Don't reach in without looking where you are sticking that hand, because you might land in acid. The next item on the list are all those chemical piles of loot. They can be fairly abundant, especially in some locations like the hospital, but it could show up in residential or commercial locations. Some have a bunch in the same room, which really helps to increase your chances of finding that acid. If nothing else, you have a fairly high chance of getting other resources and that beaker, which might otherwise be really hard to find. In commercial buildings, you often find utility carts. Always loot them for acid. It's not very common, but you might get lucky. Lockers are another fairly surprising find. I always thought that they're mostly clothing and armor, but apparently they sometimes have a bunch of other items, including acid in them. I admit, I often give these a miss simply as I expect to find clothing, but it can pay off with some acid if lucky. If you're hitting up working stiff tools and the crates, as you always should, you also sometimes can find that acid, but loot these regardless because you'll get tools and other building and crafting material regardless. And the same goes for construction crates. They are awesome for finding building supplies in general and acid, so I always loot them when I see them. Finally, if you really don't get lucky, always check your local trader. Acid does show up now and then, and while it's likely to be in limited supplies, like one if it does show up, buy it when it appears. And finally, make sure you look out for Wasteland Treasures Volume 3, which says acid is an extremely rare and powerful crafting agent. I figured out this tip to sometimes harvest a little from cars and medical equipment. Adds a chance to harvest acid from cars, medical equipment, and acid barrels. This is supremely useful. So if you can loot it or even buy it at the traders, definitely do that. What does this mean? Well, when you find these pill cases, loot them and then you wrench them because you have a pretty high chance of getting acid by simply breaking it down. That makes the early find of this book super useful, and just break down all those pill cases when you find them. Interestingly enough, You have the chemical pals and the medical pals, and just breaking them down as opposed to looting them actually gives you a pretty high chance of getting asset, assuming you've read the Wasteland Treasure book. So you might want to consider doing that, just wrenching them instead of looting them. And with the Wasteland Treasure book, oh, go look for these green barrels as well. You'll obviously be able to tell that these are hazardous, but they can give you a bunch of asset simply by wrenching them. And there you have it, a ton of locations to scavenge that asset. I would say an early find of that Wasteland Treasure book can be invaluable, as it really increases the chance of finding loot by breaking down the correct items hugely. So, still, if you can't find the asset, well, make sure to thumbs up this video and subscribe. I guarantee you'll find some asset sometime, somewhere, maybe. See you next time.
Special thanks to the great patrons supporting the channel. If you would like to join the vetted community and support these videos, do follow the Patreon link.